are here for another Facebook Live at Flyin Miata. We're actually in the shop this time. We're going to talk about LED bulbs. So we've sold LEDs for a little bit now, and the bulbs are kind of a new thing. So why do you want bulbs? Because they're shiny and new, and it's the latest technology and all that kind of stuff. Although, to be fair, LEDs have been around for a long time. But LEDs really are great in most ways. They use a lot less energy. A little bit of a qualifier on that one I'll get to in a minute. They last a very long time. They're brighter, and we carry different brightnesses, so you can choose kind of what brightness you want. And also, let me back up to the beginning. As per usual, I have forgotten, if you have questions, please leave them in the comments. We'll get to them towards the end, but we will get to them for you. So anyway, they also have a much quicker response. So I can show you on this car, the left side is all old school incandescent stuff. The right side is the new LED stuff. So we'll just do, so these are the taillights. And you can probably, well, I already told you, but you can probably guess which one is which. So you can see the LED is quite a bit brighter. And that's still the taillight, not the brake light. The other thing, and we had a question about this, which I'll just answer now. Someone was asking, they don't like it when you can see the individual bulb. Part of that is kind of nature of the taillight design, and if you want to get away from that, you need to change the taillights. Part of that is the bulb, and part of that is a good bulb versus a bad bulb. So you can see on the incandescent side, you can actually see the filament that is glowing in there. On the LED side, you can maybe kind of sort of, if you really look at it, you know, you can tell that the light is coming from the middle, but it's nowhere near as much of a pinpoint. And a lot of that comes from the good bulbs that we use. And I'll get to who makes our bulbs in a minute here. But this is kind of the dimmer version. I don't know if you can see in there, but there's just a ring of LEDs all the way around. There's a kind of a screen, if you will, to diffuse the light a little bit. This is the brighter version, and it has the giant LEDs on the outside, and then it has one big guy on the end there, and it's got a big lens on it. And all this is made so that it diffuses the light more, because that's generally not something that LEDs do, and that's one of the many reasons you want good LEDs as opposed to bad LEDs. One of the other big benefits, I will always notice this on kind of older but not much older cars that have an LED third brake light but incandescent normal brake lights, and you can always see that the third brake light comes on first and then the brake lights kind of come on afterwards. You can see that on this car with the turn signals. So if I turn that on, you can see how this one kind of comes on and comes off and comes on and comes off. And this one is on and off. There's no middle ground. It is on or it is off. This one, it can kind of be warming up or cooling down. So just, it gives you that much more of kind of a split second reaction type of thing, you know, in traffic to keep people from running into you. Theoretically, it's, you know, a third of a second is 30 feet at whatever miles per hour. I did not do that math, so, but the point remains. So, and you can also get into different aesthetics. So you can see we've got the, our corner markers that are not bulbs, which is not really what we're talking about, but it is, that is one unit. I'll turn them off so you can see what it looks like when they're not illuminated. But that's not a bulb, that's a full replacement. And we've been selling those for a while. We also have them on the ND here. And you know, we've got the license plate, housings. This is a complete housing, not just a bulb. We do sell just the bulbs as well. And then you've got the sequential board in here as well. So the The other unique thing we can do is a thing called switchbacks. So that's, I'll show you on this car, that's when you turn the parking lights on, instead of that amber glow, you get a white light, kind of like a mini headlight type of thing. And then when you turn your turn signals on, that turns off and it turns to amber. So we can show you this on this car. So that's the parking light, obviously. And then when you turn, when you change it to turn signal, it changes amber. So that's kind of a daytime running light kind of sort of thing. Brief preview, we are working on a kit for to turn the switchbacks into actual DRLs, where you just turn the key on and the lights are on. I don't have an ETA on you or for you on that one, but we are working on it, make an easy thing to make a tiny little car actually visible. So let me see, turn the lights off before I forget here. So why do you want our LEDs? Most of our LEDs are made by Diode Dynamics. They're made in the US. They have their own manufacturing, they have their own R&D, they have a 3-year warranty. They're a very, very solid company. And that's kind of part of the problem with LEDs, is that everyone and their brother makes LEDs. And how do you know which ones are good? How do you know which ones are bad? This one looks good, but is it gonna last 3 days or is it gonna last 30 years? The Diode Dynamics, they make very good products. They stand behind their products. We evaluated a number of different options, and they stood out. So we very much like those. Not all of our products are Diode Dynamics, because they don't make every single application that we need, but the vast majority are, for sure. They are also built with constant current circuitry with transient suppression. I'm not an electrical engineer. I can't tell you what that means, but I can tell you it results in long life and no flickering. So if somebody else can enlighten me, please do. So why would you maybe not want LEDs? They are more expensive. Now, when you net it out, they are not more expensive because they last so much longer than incandescent, but an LED bulb is more expensive than an incandescent bulb. So. Again, what I was talking about earlier with the cheap ones having kind of a pinpoint light, that's not a problem with ours, but that is the thing to watch out for. One of the biggest things is that you need to address the hyperflash situation. So what is hyperflash? Hyperflash is when the circuitry in your car says there's not enough resistance in that bulb, so something is burned out, so I'm going to blink really fast so that you know that this is burned out and you need to address it. Well, LEDs, because they use less energy, they have less resistance, they will blink really quickly on a normal system unless you address that somehow. So there are a couple of different ways to address it. You can just put a resistor in line. Sometimes that's the only way to solve it. The ND, ironically, is a good example of that. On the earlier cars, we can actually replace the flasher itself. So depending on what year you're talking about, the solution is different. This one, I can't remember the name, which specific generation, I apologize. I think it's the 03 to 05. Anyway, don't hold me to that. This one's a plug-in, easy peasy. Take your old one out, plug the new one in, done. This one is slightly more complicated, because you have to wire it in, but otherwise no big deal. And we have directions for that. And that solves the problem again without doing the resistor. If you do the resistor, it'll work fine, but it is still gonna consume the same amount of energy as an incandescent. And the resistor will get a little warm. It's not gonna light anything on fire, but don't put your hand on it, you know, that type of thing. And for the NAs specifically, we actually take the stock, well, we buy brand new relays or flasher units, which is why it's kind of expensive. But we take that, we disassemble it, we remove one resistor in particular, we solder a new one in place, and there you go. Now that flasher unit is specifically for LEDs. So that is helpful as well. So upcoming stuff. If you watched the 3D printing one I did a couple weeks ago, we've got a visor plate setup that's coming soon. Remove the visors and you've got lights that will go in there, hooked up to the dome light, same behavior, you know, with that switch, with doors opening, so on and so forth. We also have gauge lighting kits that are coming soon. We will have them in red, green, and blue if you're really looking for the oddball. And then also, I missed this, but we have headlights for NBs and NCs. We don't have NA headlights currently. That may change in the future. And the NDs already have LED headlights, so congratulations. You didn't have to buy any parts. I think that is it. So we did get a bunch of questions. Yes, Travis is telling me you have a question.
That's a great question.
Yes.
Someone was asking where the flasher unit is on a 1991 and how hard it is to replace.
So that's a good question. It is above the steering column and below the gauge cluster. How hard it is to replace depends, is directly related to your flexibility. It is not particularly difficult to replace it specifically. It is quite a bit more challenging to actually get to the place that it resides in. So upside down, in the footwell, that kind of thing. So, yes, Travis.
Just a simple request. Would you mind just walking around the car and pointing out all the bulbs and LED lights that we do have, just so people know all the options that are available?
Sure. I will preface this with, I am not the LED expert here. Kyle is. He was unable to join us. But I will, Kyle, my phone is on. If I say anything wrong, ping me and we will answer those questions. Okay, so here, we will turn all the lights on so we can see. So we have reverse lights, and again, if you want to see a comparison, it's definitely a much cooler light. For the reverse lights, we were going for the most light possible, and we do have two different levels, depending on your budget and whether you're looking to blind people behind you and all that fun stuff. But we do have the reverse lights. We've got the brake and turn, or excuse me, brake and tail. We've got the third brake light. We have the license plate lights. These are not them, so please don't judge these. These are still incandescent, and I can tell because my hand is warm now. Turn signals, corner markers, dome light. You know, on the early NAs, it's here. On the later NAs and NBs, it's here. We will have the visor light kits here shortly, and they make a spectacular difference. You actually have usable light in there. It's pretty impressive. Gauge illumination kits, including the odometer bulbs specifically for NBs. NAs don't need that. Front corners, front turn / parking, and we do have those in normal, as well as the switchback that this car has. And unbelievably, the other side of the car is the same. So we do not have the NA headlights now. That was a question. I'll get to that in a second. And that does apply to all of the cars. We may not have every single bulb for every single car. I think there's specific year ranges that are a little weird. But we have headlights for the, and again, I'm not the expert here, so, but I believe the NB, NC. We have fog lights for the NB and NC. We have the side markers, or side turn signals for the ND. And these, I'll just talk about them briefly here. And we'll turn this thing off. So these we have in clear or smoke, and we have in normal or, oh yeah, look, that's very convenient. I bet Travis planned that. And we have in normal or sequential. So you can see the sequential lights up like that. And unbelievably, the non-sequential just blinks. But it's the same shape. It's just the same bar. And actually, Travis, if you want to come around to the front, we can do a comparison here of LED on the driver right on this side, incandescent on this side. And one of the kind of neat things to me with the ND specifically, if I can reach in there, is that you can see. So in this one, you see that orange LED, or excuse me, incandescent bulb. And it's, I mean, I don't know, personal preference, but whatever. But on this side, you can't see any of the orange. And if you look closely, you can see like the pretty nice machined body of the LED itself. So that's another, if you're a detail person, that's another kind of neat thing. So any other questions for now? All right. Well, good. That's not a problem because I have a whole list of them. I do not, however, have them memorized. So let's see. Okay, so why are LEDs so much brighter than stock when outside the housing but reduced to almost the same as stock after you put it back inside? So I kind of talked about that kind of a little bit here. A lot of that has to do with cheap LEDs, and you have a pinpoint of light, but it's not intelligently diffused, so it doesn't kind of light up the entire housing. The other thing is that the housing itself, you can kind of see, the texture is all on the inside, but you can kind of see the texture, so it's going to diffuse the light as well and bring it down a little bit. As you saw earlier, with this example, with our LED bulbs anyway, excuse me, it is quite a bit brighter with the good stuff. So kind of depends on what you're looking at, but if you buy the good stuff, that shouldn't really be the case. Where to find bulbs for the license plate? The 89 size LEDs are proving hard to find. Well, we are your place. We do have those bulbs, the 89 and the 67. I think there are some kind of difference that I am not 100% aware of, but they're effectively interchangeable. And we do have the 67s. The part number is M28-12000. So punch that into our website. That'll come up and you get your bulbs right there. Easy peasy. Okay, I bought the corner marker LED kit and it came with reflective DOT stickers. What's the best way to install the stickers? So that's basically the corner markers are great. They look awesome. They are not retro-reflective. So that means that when you shine a light on them, when they're not powered, but when you shine a light on them, they do not shine that light back at you, which means that it's going to be difficult to see your car at night, and technically they are probably not going to be street legal in your area. So we include those stickers. It's your prerogative whether or not you want to put them on your car, but in order to be legal, you should. Now, what's the best way to put them on? Just put them somewhere nearby. Whatever makes sense for you is what I would suggest. I don't know if there are any kind of legal definitions about size, if you can trim that sticker down to make it smaller, so it's not quite as obvious, but these are the rules in the world in which we have to live. So we kind of try to navigate that carefully. Okay, I want DRL replacements for the ND that have switchback function as indicators. That would be really cool. I would also like that. What he's talking about, he or she, is on, yeah, we can't show you on Andy because it has our brake duct. Oh, actually both of these have our brake duct kit. Okay, so use your imagination, and usually there are DRLs right here. That is a big, complicated, expensive housing, and I believe we would have to replace the entire thing in order to turn it into a switchback. So short version, good suggestion. I like it. I'd love to make it happen. I am a little less confident that it is actually realistic. But I will talk to the LED people about it to see what we can do. Don't hold your breath. If it happens, it'll probably be a while. What else do we have? Okay, do you guys sell LED headlights? Because I bought some off of Amazon, but they don't really work. This can happen. Not everything off of Amazon is bad. There are plenty of good things, but you got to kind of filter a little bit. So yes, we do sell headlights. this is an example. It's actually quite impressive construction. Big metal housing with a heat sink on there. It also has a heat sink on this piece as well, and there's a little fan in there. And they do durability testing on it. Again, 3-year warranty. Very, very good stuff. Now, for NAs, we don't currently have that. There's a possibility of us having a bulb in the future. We're only going to carry that if it's good and if it actually works. It's not, hey, it's an LED, so it's magically better. That's not really the case. That's why we don't just sell generic whatever. That's why we sell the good stuff. So anyway, that having been said, the nice one that I like is a rigid. It's a 7-inch round. It's a full replacement housing. And it's kind of modern without being really ostentatious about it and all the different projectors and the goofy halos and all that stuff. And hey, if that floats your boat, that's awesome. There are a million different options in 7-inch round headlights. But for my 2 cents, that's the one I prefer. It does have very impressive light output. Now that I can directly segue into another question we had, which wasn't really a question, but a comment, I suppose, which is that LED bulbs are not good in snow because they're not going to melt the snow off of the lens. This is true. There's no argument. Now, on a not headlight, you're not melting the snow anyway, so it doesn't make any difference. On a headlight, no, you're absolutely right. That is a downside. Now, the good side is that the other 98% of the time, you're saving energy and you're putting out much better light. Now, Rigid does, and I think they still make this, maybe not, but they do have a version that actually has a heated element in the face of it. So that is an option you can look into if that's a concern for you. So anyway. Okay, my question regarding LEDs is, I was doing some reading on the forums and lots of people mentioned when installing some of the LEDs, you have to reverse the polarity. Are your kits plug and play? Do I have to do any weird changes because I am not good when it comes to electrical stuff and I've been considering buying LEDs for my car? There are obviously cheaper options, but cheaper means poorer quality. Ding, ding, ding. Our kits are plug and play. The only exception to that is you've got to splice in the wires for this for this flasher. You've got to wire in the resistor if you're going to go that route instead, or if that's the only route. Outside of that, plug and play. I mean, all these mounts are the exact same as the stock setup. Pop it in, go on your merry way. And if we're not talking about certain turn signals, just bolt it in and go. No big deal. No reversing polarity, nothing weird. Will there be any information for us NC owners? Yep. These, and I don't know if it's this specific bulb, I'm sorry, but we do have headlight bulbs for NCs. Maybe not these specific bulbs, but these bulbs, or we do have similar bulbs for NCs. We've got a number of different options on the website, but there's an LED lighting bundle upgrade, I think is what it's called. And we have one of those for all four generations, including the neglected NC owners. So we do have that for you guys. What benefits does the new flasher have over resistor? I think I basically covered this, but the really short version is the resistor is a Band-Aid. The flasher is solving the actual problem instead of the symptom of the problem kind of thing. So either one works. The flasher is definitely the right way to do it. Is there a video for wiring install for an NB? That's a little open-ended. I'm going to assume that you're talking about the rear side markers because they are not powered on an NB. If you got our setup, you can power them, but actually doing so requires some wiring. So basically, you need to find a socket that will plug into the back of the corner light. Excuse me. I'm not sure if something like that is available in the aftermarket or not. You can always go to salvage yards and such. And from there, it's just a matter of butt connectors and some wiring. Hook them into the taillight wiring in the taillights. And they'll work fine. We were actually going to do a kit on that. We had a number of requests for it. And Mazda had a harness to bolt right in, mostly, at least connect to the corner markers, and they don't make that anymore. So, sorry, there is no off-the-shelf solution for that, but it's also not a particularly difficult wiring job. Can I splice these into working with blinkers? So if you're talking about, if your question was, I want to make the corner markers blink with the turn signals, how do I do that? Sure, just take the wiring and disconnect it from its original place, connect it to the turn signal, and make sure you get your polarity right, because it does matter on LEDs. Ours are pre-set up for that, but if you're cutting and splicing wires, you got to make sure to get that right. But anyway, if you do that, I've never tried it, but I don't see any reason why it wouldn't work. I'll give you a full refund on that advice if it doesn't, but you'll probably be fine. Is there a way to get soft LED taillights like on modern vehicles? I'm not a fan of visible bulbs. So again, I kind of touched on this earlier. The really short version is either replace the taillight housing altogether, or our bulbs actually do a pretty good job of that, as you saw with the demonstration here. And don't buy cheap LEDs. What is the suggestion for taillights for an NA? Our bulbs, they work really well. If you are looking for a different aesthetic, that is up to you. Aesthetics are obviously very personal. There may or may not be a lot of different options, but there are different options, and what is awesome for one person is going to be hideous to the other. So I don't have a whole lot of advice for you, other than if you want to make the existing setup much better, our bulbs are a great way to do that. How do they differ from the carbon Miata variant? I'm going to assume that we're talking about the corner markers. And to be honest, I don't know. It's possible that they don't. It's possible they're the exact same thing. Ours are in stock in the US, so I'm going to guess that they're much easier to get. But carbon Miata makes good stuff. They're good people. I have zero problem with them. So if you want to get their stuff, no worries. Do we offer sequential turn signals? Yes, we do. I don't know if Travis got the rear guys. So that's what they look like. That is also the only vehicle we offer sequential turn signals for. I would say it's also arguably the only one it kind of makes sense on, because you have a long turn signal. You know, this is just a big dot. So personal preference, but I feel like a sequential turn signal in there would look a little weird. I feel like it looks really appropriate here. So yes, we do for one generation. Yes, question.
We have a customer who is replacing the 3 taillight brake lights and was wanted to double check and make sure that he didn't have to do any wiring.
So the only qualifier on that, and I apologize, I forgot this, is that there is some really goofy cruise control business going on. I'm not sure of the specifics, but the really short version is it goes through the brake light circuit. So if you don't correct the resistance change, your cruise control won't work. We do have a fix for that. It's on the website. Make sure to check that box if you have cruise control. If you don't have cruise control, or you couldn't care less if it works, then no. Plug it in and you're good to go.
Covered this, but somebody asking about NA and NB dome lights.
So if you're late to the party, we do have dome lights for, I don't have any here, but anyway, LED dome lights. They do have kind of a cover on them to diffuse the light. It is brighter. I believe we have a warm and a cool, whether you're looking for kind of the yellowish incandescent or just the brightest light possible. We are also working on I don't know what we're going to call it, but basically a kit to replace the visors and put dome lights in their place. And that is quite bright. I mean, and not like blinding, but you actually have usable light, because the stock ones, as I'm sure we all know, are just about worthless. So any other questions? All right. So what else do we have here? For turn signals, what's the best way to upgrade to LEDs without making it signal really fast? I refer you back to the resistor and flasher conversation. Again, LED turn signals will blink fast unless you do something about them, and your options are flasher, correct solution but more expensive and a little bit more complicated, arguably, or the resistor, kind of a Band-Aid, but still works fine. A little bit easier to install, generally speaking. You at least don't have to be a contortionist to get into the footwell. If you could talk on how to attach the accompanying resistors for the front LED turn signals on ND, that would be very helpful. I've been procrastinating on install since I'm not 100% sure on how to do it. Okay, so I apologize. I meant to grab props for this, but I neglected to. Basically, our resistors come with one of three options. The resistors for the ND parts, for the ND full replacement parts anyway, this is a turn signal, comes with this guy, are plug-in. You just plug it in, you go on your merry way, no big deal. If you have one that needs to be spliced in, the manufacturer includes what we call vampire clamps. It's basically a little metal piece that pierces the insulation of the wire. We're not real big fans of those. And I'm sure they work most of the time, but we've had way too many problems where they either don't pierce the insulation at all or pierce it enough that you get a connection originally and then you drive a half mile down the road and you lose it, or it cuts through the wire altogether. So we're not big fans of that. What we do is we include three-way butt connectors. So you cut the stock wire in half, you put one of the resulting ends into one end of the butt connector, you wrap your new wire from the resistor around the other end of that cut wire, put it into the other end of the butt connector, crimp it, and then heat shrink it. Always heat shrink, because heat shrink is a strain relief, which is its main purpose, in addition to the waterproofing, which I suspect is what most people think. And then it's good. That is a long-term reliable solution. So that is the way that you do it. We do have instructions for that. If you can't find them on our website, just drop us an email. Support, new website, our new email address. All of our addresses are now support@flyinmiata.com. So drop us an email and we can get you some directions for that. And that is all of the questions that I have from beforehand. Are there any more questions? All right. Well, thank you for following along with us as always. Hopefully most of you have picked up on this, but we are here every Thursday, 2:00-ish Mountain Time. As always, if you have questions, leave them in the comments. We will get to them. This video will be on YouTube later. We will get to questions there as well. If you need anything else, again, support@flyinmiata.com. Make sure to follow us on all the socials and all that business to keep up to date with our stuff. And thank you very much. We'll see you next time.